shoot it up for over 300 as a member of the Red Wings. For Patrick Kane, it's only game number 20 for Detroit, but it's the 1,200th of his NHL career. Kane back in the lineup after missing the last seven due to injury. Back in the Detroit lineup after missing the last four with injury. This is Detroit's first game in 10 days, their first out of the break. Here's Lucas Raymond in, cuts in front, he scores! On Kids Day in Detroit, the youngest player in the game opens the scoring.
Canucks had a forecheck that didn't create any sort of physical contact, and Perron is about to finish his shift, just give it to Raymond. Drives to the net. And Tyler Myers doesn't take his stick or the puck. And just Smith is down a little bit early. Doesn't use it.
Jake Walman feeds down. Dylan Larkin tried to put one in front. That was broken up, but the Wings get the puck back. Walman, long shot, knocked away by DeSmith. McCabe tried to feed back to JT Miller. That was intercepted, and the puck is sent down into Vancouver territory. Hughes checked by Robbie Fabry, who centers the puck. Tipped on goal, stopped by DeSmith, and he's able to cover. Canucks get the power play here. Perron's off for Hooker. Chance for Vancouver to tie the game. Patterson down to Miller now. Lindholm, it got to the goal line, and it's held out by Lyons.
Not so aggressive, so they move the puck around quickly, and Lindholm gets this shot past the blocker, off the goaltender. You can hear the ping up here.
Oh, shots are now 8-5 in favor of Vancouver. Here comes Hoaglander. Patterson going to that. Hoaglander shoots. Hit the post. Nils Hoaglander, who's the youngest Canuck in this game, almost scored on Kids Day himself. This one, youngest Canuck came close. Hoaglander off the post. Settles in for the start of period number two. JT Compher wins the faceoff, and Ben Sherratt shoots the puck in from center. Try to wrist shot. That's off his stick. Broke the stick. DeBrincat will try to kick the puck along. Suter gets it. Tried to feed it back to Hughes. That hit the skate of Sider. Canucks maintain control. Peronik with room. He shoots. Tipped in. Nils Hoaglander. As Lyon complains that he was tripped, I think. But Hoaglander on the redirect. And again on Kids Day, it's the youngest wing and the youngest Canuck that have the goals. It's 1-1.
And it's Doug Free. And now the high forward, Lucas Raymond, doesn't know what to do. Gives it up to Hronek, had his eyes up, and see Hoaglander presenting his blade. I mean, he's in front of his check. And the goaltender got...
The major penalty is half over. Just under 2.5 minutes to go in this power play for Detroit. Here's a chance for Fabry, stopped by DeSmith, and the Canucks have a chance to break out. Here's Fabry to the goal line. Puck center, Compher check. Peronik's out of the box. He's got a breakaway. And he scores in his return to Detroit. Philip Peronik out of the box gives the Canucks the lead after Vancouver killed off 7 minutes of power play time.
Detroit. Excellent penalty killing. Intercepted. And Peronik's right out of the box. Shoulder fake at that back leg to kick, making it look like he's going to follow through with the shot. Continues on the forehand. Lyon just goes on his belly. And that will silence the crowd. Fourth of the season.
Elias Pettersson sweeps the puck in behind for Hoaglander, working on Jeff Petrie. Nice move to find some room. Hoaglander to the blue line. Myers fakes the pass, now sends it to Hronek. Here's Suter turning with a shot, missed. Pettersson scores on the rebound. Third point of the afternoon for Elias Pettersson. And the Canucks with two goals here in the short order, three in the period. And they've taken a 3-1 lead.
Distance themselves here from Detroit, and it's Hoaglander's hard work. This shot coming through is gonna miss the net, but he's gonna keep his feet moving behind the net. Here's the goal from Pettersson, the ricochet off the back wall. Done to be able to step out and elude Sherratt.
DeBrincat in, wrist shot it. Reaching in was Ian Cole to tip the puck out of play, and the players are going to gather in the far corner. All 10 skaters are in on this one.
Yeah, this is brewing. After that puck was going up into the netting, Rasmussen got a bump with Juleson, and then
DeBrincat dropped the gloves with Cole here. one glove anyways, throwing little rabbit punches with the left hand, and now Cole gets loose.
Cole's club went to the crowd.
Oh, an uppercut from Cole, and then one with the other hand, and that'll be it.
Yeah.
Could have landed one more, but just cocked the fist and let up. And sometime after. So the Canucks to start the period, as they finished the period, down to four defensemen in the absence of Nikita Zadorov, who received a match penalty earlier, and Cole, who's serving his fighting major. Put one to the middle, sit back to Sider. Moritz Sider, wrist shot, blocked by Lindholm. 10 seconds to go on the power play. Myers hits Raymond again. Puck is centered, they score, Sprong. Daniel Sprong, with just 5 seconds to go on the power play, gets the Wings within a goal.
Got spread out below the goal line, and Sprong just stayed out of the front of the net. Myers below the goal line, Hronek under the goal line, and Sprong sweeps it right underneath Casey DeSmith.
Rasmussen gets it. And the lower mainland native lifts the puck into the Vancouver zone. Rasmussen battling behind the goal. Now it's sent to the blue line by Fisher. Long shot, tipped in. Rasmussen just under the bar. Michael Rasmussen against his hometown team has tied the game 7:51 into the third.
The goal line, and then just sent up to the left point. There's Rasmussen shielding the puck. And then getting to the front of the net, this goes off. Like his knee, played to the stick and passed Casey DeSmith. I mean, that was in and out in a hurry.
Here's Hughes. Miller back to Hughes. Fakes the shot. Takes it wide on Kopp. Hughes now shoots. Blocked. Besser in the rebound. Stop. They bang away. And somehow it stays out as Lyon had the right pad down and then Sider trying to help out along the goal line.
Quinn Hughes buys some time here. To his forehand at the net. Goes off Sider, poked by a couple of Canuck forwards, Besser and Miller, and then they're trying to all muscle this over the goal line.
Lindholm as well.
Off hit the toe of his skate. And out of the line, he kept his leg against the post for as long as he could. Pettersson was.
Philip Hronek puts one towards the front. That was blocked by Sider. Garland can't come up with the puck. Here come the Wings, three of them. Kane. Across, Conker, stop by DeSmith, rebound, Perron, bobbled it, couldn't get a good shot away.
Huck enough to get it between the pipes. And this one, look at that, Canuck players everywhere.
10 seconds remaining, both teams want to make sure they get a point here. Fans will come to their feet here as the Wings score twice in the third. And Dylan Larkin. This is his last gasp to extend his league-long point streak of 12 games. Red Wings control first. Raymond trying to get away from Pettersson. Might have grabbed him for a second. Trying to steal the puck, but Raymond pulls away, and now Pettersson has to hustle. Sent ahead. Walman's behind Hughes, and there's going to be at least a penalty here. Penalty shot in overtime for Jake Walman.
Posted up by the far blue line.
Penalty shot for cross-checking.
He's calling it a penalty shot because of a cross-check. Nice pickup from Walman. And there's the penalty shot called because of this cross-check to the back.
Walman has an overtime winner this year, but it wasn't on a penalty. This is the first penalty shot of his career. Casey DeSmith has stopped one of two in his NHL career. With the game on the line. He did the gritty last time with his overtime winner against Montreal. Walman has the fans in a frenzy here.
Walman's looking at the puck. Then he gets his eyes up and gets it past the glove. And then the dance. He's got his head down, so Smith can't really read his eyes of where he's going to put it.